Well, but the big story is coming in from the Air Chief Marshal B.S. Dhanoa, who has dismissed accounts refuting India's version of its airstrikes in Pakistan, confirming that the Indian Air Force did hit terror targets during the Balakot preemptive airstrikes. Air Chief Marshal also confirming that the Indian Air Force cannot count the number of casualties and only the government will be able to confirm that number. When he was asked about the usage of the MiG-21 Bison that was used against the F-16, B.S. Dhanoa, the Air Force Chief Marshal, said that MiG is capable, advanced and has better air-to-air missile systems. The Air Chief Marshal also saying that anti-terror operation is still underway in Pakistan.
The target has been clearly amplified by the Foreign Secretary in his statement.
Yeah.
And of course, if he planned to hit the target, we hit the target. Otherwise, why would he have responded?
ANI, please.
If he had dropped bombs in the jungle, there's no need for him to respond. That statement will be made by the government. No, I mean, Air Force is not in a position to clarify that how many people were inside that way. We don't count human casualties. We count what targets have we hit or not hit.
Time 7 day, please.
The bomb damage assessment that is done post a mission calculates the number of the target you've been hit or you've not been able to hit. We can't count how many people have died. That depends on how many people were there. I will not comment on the ongoing operations because they are still ongoing. But MiG-21 Bison is capable. It has been upgraded. It is not the old MiG-21 bis. It's got a better weapon system. It's got better radars, better air-to-air missiles, a radar warning receiver, chaff flares, whatever it takes to make it, from third generation to 3.5 generation or so. So it is an upgraded aircraft, and we fight with all the aircraft in our inventory.
Okay, let me go straight across now to Executive Editor Gaurav Savant. We also have Shiv Arur. We have Abhishek Bhalla also joining us on the broadcast. Gaurav, amid a massive political slugfest on the Indian Air Force airstrikes comes the Air Force Chief's big statement that it was the job and duty of the Air Force fighters to hit targets, which they successfully achieved, and not the task to count casualties at that time. What are your thoughts and what are the kind of reactions that you're getting after the Air Chief Marshal just addressed that press conference?
The Air Chief simply stated facts. Indian Air Force went into Pakistan, went into Khyber Pakhtunkhwa, destroyed a terrorist training camp at Balakot, and the bomb damage assessment, and that is what is critical. The bomb damage assessment shows that the bombs that the Indian Air Force dropped, it acquired its targets. Now, with whatever buildings they wanted to bring down, whatever structures they wanted to bring down, they were successful in bringing them down. What happened subsequently? Were there 2, 10, 20, 200, 300 people inside? According to the Air Chief, it's not his job to find that out. He's done his job. Now it's for human intelligence or electronic intelligence or signal intelligence or a combination or satellite intelligence and a combination of all for the government to assess the damage done by the Indian Air Force airstrikes. And the fact that there has been damage across is an indicator that the Pakistan Air Force tried to strike back the next day. Had it only been trees, why would they have hit back, is his point.
Absolutely. Shiv, critics and experts have also questioned the rationale of using the MiG-21s in combat air patrol. And today we heard the Air Force Chief strongly defending the use of the MiG-21s. Would that now silence the critics and all those who were questioning the use of the MiG-21s?
I just want to say, before I answer that question, and it's a very important one, Avantika, about the MiG-21, which the Air Chief has completely laid that argument to rest. And we've also been saying that the MiG-21 in its upgraded form has silenced critics around the world by bringing down an F-16. And the Air Chief has basically endorsed that view, and silenced critics, not just here in India, but around the world. But the messaging by Air Chief Marshal Dhanoa today has to be seen very carefully, because it really represents the nobility of the armed forces, Avantika. He said, we do not count human casualties. That's not what our job is. We have targets and we've hit those targets. Now, if you run those words in your head once, you understand what the difference is between governments and the armed forces.
Yes.
Here is a professional service that was given a task to do in a certain environment, and it has attacked those targets. And remember, the Air Chief is saying these words, Avantika, in the middle of ugly political slugfest going on between the BJP and the Congress, where you have multiple Congress leaders saying, proof dikhao, from Kapil Sibal to Sidhu to Digvijay Singh to others, saying, where is the proof? Which has been an embarrassment as far as the Air Force is concerned, because they've got the proof, but it's not up to them to put the proof out, and it shouldn't be anyone's case that such sensitive proof be actually put out. And that's why you had the Air Chief Marshal also say, Avantika, if our bombs only hit jungles and forested area, then why is Pakistan jumping to defend? If it didn't hit any targets, they should be totally happy.
Absolutely. You know, before I come to you, Abhishek, let's just play out those reactions from the opposition, those questions being raised by various opposition leaders who have been demanding evidence from the Indian Air Force and from the government on putting out those casualty figures. Let's just play out those reactions first.
In fact, the Prime Minister should, in fact, answer one question. How is it that the international media, which includes the Washington Post, the New York Times, the Guardian, the Daily Telegraph, the Jane's Information Journal, Reuters, while all these international agencies are saying that there is no proof of militants being killed at Balakot.
Ek taraf bayan de rahe hain, dusri taraf Ahluwalia ji ek bayan de rahe hain. Abhi unki tamam chunavi vaade jo unhone gaddari ki dhoka diya janta ko, ab aami ke kandho pakad kar वो उसको ठीक करने का प्रयास कर रहे हैं। इससे ज्यादा आर्म्ड फोर्सेस का अपमान क्या हो सकता है?
Abhishek, that's the charge by the opposition. They are now targeting the government. They're accusing the government of milking the airstrikes for their own political gains. But the Air Force Chief's statement that's coming amid a lot of silence from the government also on the exact casualty figures after the Indian Air Force attacked the biggest training facility in Balakot. Can we expect now those figures to be released? Because it's been very clearly stated by the Air Force that they're not the ones who's going to be releasing that kind of confidential information.
Well, Avantika, if you see the way the defense establishment and the Air Force have spoken about this incident, they have been very consistent. This is not for the first time that the Air Force has come on record and said that they cannot make an assessment of the casualties. That's a political row that is ensuing. And what was very significant is that the Air Chief Marshal was unruffled. He has not gone drawn into the political slugfest that's going on.
True.
He's plain speaking. He's made it very clear that this is not the job of the Air Force. What the job of the Air Force was to identify the targets and hit them, and they hit them successfully. That's what the consistent stand of the defense establishment has been, even though there has been a political row from both the sides. Amit Shah this morning has said that 250 terrorists were killed. The opposition has been gunning for the government, saying, give us proof. But as far as the Air Force is concerned, they are sticking to their stand that we were given a task. We succeeded in it. We are not going to tell you what the casualties are because there's no way to make an assessment.
Absolutely. And Gaurav, another very important point, that the operation very much is still on, which means that the return of the pilot from Pakistan to India hasn't really led to a complete de-escalation.
That's the point that the Army, the Navy and the Air Force have repeatedly been making, that the return of the pilot does not mean de-escalation. You remember at the tri-services press conference also, they showed evidence of a Pakistani missile, a US-made air-to-air missile, the AMRAAM, being used, and that too at a military target. So the first escalation is actually by Pakistan, and there will be a response. Now, on top of that, Avantika, sources also say that one terrorist training camp and an important facility of Jaish-e-Mohammed, that was taken out. But the threat posed by Pakistan state-sponsored terror to India remains. So if there is once again an imminent threat that terrorists in Pakistan could target people in India, Indian forces will do what is required to be done. And the signal both from the Air Chief and earlier from the Navy, when the Navy said that we are on alert and we are deployed, these are very, very significant statements. And of course, on ground armies responding to Pakistan's ceasefire violations.
Absolutely. Supriya Bhardwaj is joining us. She, in fact, very closely covers the Congress party. Supriya, What does the Congress now have to say after the press conference by the Air Force chief, who clearly said that the Indian Air Force was successful in hitting targets, the mission was achieved quite successfully, and it is not their duty to count casualties? Are they satisfied now?
Well, Avantika, as far as the Congress party is concerned, they are maintaining that there was no question being raised as to whether the airstrikes took place or not. What they are targeting is that why there are different numbers which are being quoted by senior BJP leaders, as well as now even by a BJP president, Mr. Amit Shah. At the same time, also the sitting ministers in the Modi regime, they are saying that why there have been numbers which have been put out. Sometimes some number says 400 casualties, some number says 300, some numbers 250. So this is what the entire opposition led by the Congress is asking for. We have seen as to how there was a united attack on the government on the issue of the numbers which are being quoted by the BJP leaders, as well as there are posters as banners which have been put across the country which are saying that 300 militants were killed by our soldiers, 400 militants were killed by our soldiers. So this is what exactly the opposition is saying. They're saying that please come out and clarify. Now the army is saying it's up to the government which has to come out and tell us what was the extent. And obviously, because the army operations, the air force operation, the navy operations are very coveted in nature, they are not supposed to reveal the strategic information. And this is what exactly the opposition leaders are saying, that we are not questioning the attack. We know that the attack took place. What we are asking is that the numbers which are regularly being quoted by different BJP leaders, as well as the government sitting ministers, that the opposition is targeting at.
Shiv, so that's the charge by the opposition on the government, that they're milking the airstrikes for politics. So what are you hearing from your sources, especially in the defense ministry? Will the defense minister speak? Will she come out with those numbers? Will there be more additional information that will be shared in the run-up to the elections?
Avantika, first off the bat, there is no doubt in anyone's mind that the airstrikes are being milked for politics, both by the government and as well as the opposition to score these brownie points. Obviously, the collateral damage in all of this is the sensitivity of the operation and the fact that both Pakistan and the world is watching us. So as we talk numbers of casualties, where is the proof, etc., etc., to score these political points before elections, neither side actually understands the damage they're actually doing to the sensitivity and the need for confidentiality of such operations. Leaving that bit aside, what the Air Chief has said is really accurate. He said, we don't count casualties, we hit targets, and we've hit those targets. Now, whether it is going to be a political decision to reveal how many battle casualties have actually taken place has to be a political decision. So far, the Ministry of Defense has provided no indication of whether they plan to release these figures. Remember, because of the political upheaval over that 300 figure, wherever it came from, becoming a hot potato issue, Avantika, I would be very surprised if the government will go ahead and provide any kind of battle damage assessment in terms of human casualties. In terms of the targets struck, we're expecting that maybe over the next few days there might be some visual evidence. But once again, I want to caution our viewers, it's going to be difficult at this point of time.
All right. Let me just once again play out what the Indian Air Force chief a short while ago said during the press conference. In fact, there were a couple of questions that were put out at him, but he remained unfazed and very clearly stated that the targets were successfully hit. And it's not the job of the Air Force to count casualties. Listen in to the Indian Air Force Chief, Air Chief Marshal B.S. Dhanoa.
The target has been clearly amplified by the Foreign Secretary in his statement.
Yeah.
And of course, if we plan to hit the target, we hit the target. Otherwise, why would he have responded?
ANI, please.
If he had dropped bombs in the jungle, there's no need for him to respond. That statement will be made by the government. Air Force is not in a position to clarify that how many people were inside it. That we don't count human casualties. We count what targets have we hit or not hit.
Time, Savinder, please.
The bomb damage assessment that is done post a mission calculates the number of the target you've been hit or you've not been able to hit. We can't count how many people have died. That depends on how many people were there.
Okay, Abhishek Bhalla is also there. In fact, he has been reporting extensively on the Pulwama strike and how the Indian Air Force launched those preemptive pre-dawn airstrikes. Now, tell me something, Abhishek. What is the situation like on the ground? Because there are many who are working very closely with the United Nations Security General to kind of ease tensions between India and Pakistan. There is global pressure, everybody urging Pakistan to back off. But what are you getting from the ground? Will the return of the pilot actually lead to a complete de-escalation between both the nations?
Well, the return of Wing Commander Abhinandan has certainly de-escalated matters to an extent, but that doesn't mean that military operations are over. In fact, the army made it very clear that they will continue to hit terror camps till Pakistan is supporting it. This was put on record in a joint press conference that they did last week. And also, there has been a continuous skirmish at the LOC in the last couple of weeks. For 2 weeks, it hasn't stopped, Avantika. In fact, just because there were air raids, you know, the story about the cross-border, the cross-LOC raids and the cross-LOC shelling did not hit headlines as it would have if there were no air raids. So the situation all along the LOC is extremely volatile, and every day, and that's very clear, I mean, there's no exaggeration about it. What I'm hearing from sources is every day there is heavy shelling, there is mortar shelling, and in fact, they are just fearing that, you know, at some point of time it might escalate and heavy arms and artillery will also be used, but it hasn't been done till now. But the situation all along the LC and also along the international border, extremely volatile.
Absolutely. And Shiv, you know, you have been covering defense for just so many years. Does it surprise you the kind of politics that we are seeing today? Isn't this one of the most biggest and historic hits by the Indian Air Force? For the very first time after decades, we are crossing over the LOC, Pakistan-occupied Kashmir, hitting terror targets inside Khyber Pakhtunkhwa and hitting the largest terror training facility. You know, what do you make of the kind of politics and the questions that are being raised and asked by the opposition?
Not surprised, even one single little bit. Let's remember there's an election coming, and in this country of ours, as much as we criticize it, love it, hate it, whatever you want to say about the politics of it, you know, this country essentially functions, the political class essentially functions, you know, between elections. So the politics is not surprising whatsoever. I just want to give our viewers a very small example, which paints an ironic picture of what politics is really about and how our netas can end up, you know, looking like buffoons sometimes. Times as well. Digvijay Singh has said that after the Osama operation, the United States had provided a lot of proof of that killing, and therefore, in a similar vein, the Indian Modi government should also do the same. A lot of people on social media and on TV have educated Digvijay Singh to say that the Osama operation is actually the worst example that any neta could pick up to actually give proof, because the United States actually provided no proof of it.
Right.
And in fact, the only real proof, if you want to call it, that exists that the operation happened is, you know, a Catherine Bigelow film called Zero Dark Thirty, which apparently realistically portrayed what happened. But in terms of material proof of the Navy SEALs conducting that operation, there is absolutely nothing, Avantika. So terrible example there by the Congress party.
Absolutely. And Abhishek, the Air Force chief making it very clear that when there is an operation, you simply go ahead and carry it out, coming in strongly defending the usage of the MiG-21s. And he said whatever planes are there inventory, it will be used no matter what, silencing the critics and all those experts who had questioned the very rationale of using the MiG-21s in carrying out and executing this operation.
Well, he's definitely backed his brave fighter pilots, and you know, that's how a military leader is, because whatever is available, they have to use that, whether it's a MiG-21 or a Rafale tomorrow. But the fact is that the Indian Air Force pilots who were operating a MiG-21 brought down an F-16, even though Pakistan has been denying it. The Indian Defense Establishment came out and gave proof of it. They displayed pictures of an MRAM missile that is exclusively used in an F-16. So as far as the Defense Establishment is concerned, the Air Force is concerned, they have been very straightforward about their operation. Of course, they can't go ahead and reveal all operational details about such a sensitive operation that was carried out, but they have given enough evidence, enough
yes.
proof that can be given at this point of time to rest the case that an airstrike took place and Balakot was hit. Whether casualties are there or not, that's not the job of the Air Force.
All right, we also have some breaking news coming in at this moment. The Prime Minister's first reaction. We've got a tweet that has been put out by the Prime Minister's office. I'm going to just read that out. It is natural and we should all believe that the armed forces and be proud of the forces. Yet I don't understand why some people are still wanting to question the forces. All right, so that's the big statement coming in there from the Prime Minister amid the fierce slugfest going on between the BJP and the Congress, with many in the Congress asking those questions. But you know, Shiv, the Congress party in its defense is saying we are not questioning the aerial strikes. We are not even questioning the intent of the armed forces. We are only asking for all these numbers that are being put out by the BJP chief in public forums and through various other means. And that is their main aim. That is the main argument, that where are these numbers coming from? If the Indian Air Force initially had said that it is premature to assess casualties, and now the Air Force chief saying that they're not the ones to count those casualties, why are these numbers being thrown up by senior leaders in the BJP?
You know, Avantika, first of all, it was probably bad strategy for the BJP chief to put out any numbers whatsoever, because, you know, if those numbers actually exist, then obviously the response is going to be, where is the proof? Because the Congress doesn't know any better, you know, as far as a strategic operation is concerned. I just want to point our viewers' attention to what the Prime Minister has just said. He's just tweeted, you just read out that tweet. He says, it's natural that we all should believe the armed forces and be proud of the forces, yet I don't understand why some people still want to question the forces. The question you asked me earlier about whether you know, the politics on both sides is going to milk you know, faith that we have in the armed forces. Well, the Prime Minister has said this at the India Today conclave, and he's saying it again here on the back of what the Air Chief has said, Avantika, saying we hit targets, it's not up to us to count human casualties. This comes on the back of it, and basically this is the Prime Minister saying, look, the Air Chief has said what he had to say, why aren't you going to believe him? Because ultimately the Congress, from Sidhu to Digvijay Singh to Kapil Sibal, perhaps others, and none of them have been reined in by Rahul Gandhi at this sensitive time, you know, are continuing to ask, where has this figure actually come on? It's very important to note that the BJP chief has used these figures. Nobody knows what the source of these figures is, but the Ministry of Defense and the Air Force have not put out any figures just yet. It's only in the political space where these figures have been floating around. So that is perhaps one of the defenses that the government and the Air Force have so far.
Absolutely, Shiv. Shiv Arur and Abhishek Bala, thank you both for joining us.
Thanks for watching the video. For more such news and updates, please like, share and subscribe to India Today. Also, check out our other great videos from our channel. We know you will love to.